Next on Gardeners Hotline, poinsettias. Come on back. Welcome to Gardeners Hotline. I'm your host, Karen Stauderman, a University of Florida Horticulture Extension agent. Today, we are featuring poinsettias. They are native to Mexico, where they are known as the flower of Christmas Eve. Poinsettias aren't poisonous or toxic, but the latex in the poinsettia sap may cause irritation to those with latex allergies. The poinsettia is a short day plant that blooms when days are short and nights are long. The extended period of darkness is the natural trigger for flowering. As a result of intensive breeding, there is over 100 different varieties of poinsettias now available in variations including burgundy, pink, peach, white, yellow, and marbled colors. Today's program will answer your questions about growing poinsettia and more. Our guest, Dr. James Barrett, a horticulture professor and expert in poinsettia, who's located in Gainesville, Florida at the University of Florida campus. Hi, Dr. Barrett. Thanks for joining us on the program today.
Hi, Karen. Thank you for having me on again. I look forward to some good questions this evening.
It's been a couple years, and there's probably a lot happened since you've been
back. There's some interesting things, and I think we'll get into talking about those.
Oh, I'm excited. But first, I know many of you want to learn about this holiday plant, so let's invite you guys to the program here and call us in with this number. It's 1-800-901-9238. Well, let's get started. Tell me a little bit, what goes on at the University of Florida that you work there?
Well, at the University of Florida, we have a large poinsettia program that involves the different components, research, the teaching activities, and then the extension service activities where we take information and deliver it to the consumers. And those work together. The research part of it, I'm a plant physiologist, and I look at what makes a plant tick, the physiology of growth and development, some of the biochemistry behind them. Do a lot of evaluation of the different varieties and how they perform, interact with the environments, different climates, different types of stress. And the extension part of it, we evaluate the varieties, and then we can tell the individual growers, the wholesale growers, the retailers, and consumers of the types of varieties that perform best in the different types of climates, whether it's a Midwestern climate or a Florida climate, Texas, that type of thing. So we're doing both research, teaching students on how to grow the plants and how to produce them, and delivering information to our clientele groups.
Well, how many years have you been doing this? When did you start?
1978.
Wow.
It's been a while, yes.
Wow, so it's pretty significant. Now, do you actually breed them, or do you just analyze them?
We do not do breeding of poinsettias. Florida is actually a bad climate for growing and breeding poinsettias, so I'm not a breeder of poinsettias. I describe myself as a movie critic. Other companies produce the varieties, and then I just tell everybody what's good and bad about them.
Okay.
And tell individual growers or plant breeders things that would work a little bit better.
Where do most of the poinsettia breeding happens? In our country, outside the country?
There are four major poinsettia breeders in the world. Three of them are located in Northern Europe, Germany, the Netherlands, and one in the Southern California, San Diego area.
Wow.
And those climates are unique climates. Poinsettias highly are varied by temperatures, light levels, culture, fertilizer, watering, those kinds of things. So the poinsettia breeders have difficulty producing plants that perform best in situations like South Texas or hotter climates, tropical climates similar to Florida.
Well, recently we were at the University of Florida in the greenhouses where you work.
Yes.
So let's take a look and see at some of the work you guys do there. And it's quite interesting.
Okay. We have the greenhouses set up. In many cases, they're relatively large, about 8,000 square foot greenhouses. We're growing Now 155 different varieties that we are evaluating. We have a commercial field day every year that growers from the southeastern part of the U.S., plant breeders come in, and we talk about the characteristics of the different varieties. Another activity that we have is very important is our Poinsettia show and sell.
Oh, sale. I like that.
Yes. In that event, we have over 1,500 visitors who come in and look at the plants. Our students grow about 5,000 different plants that they have for sale. There, we get a lot of really good information when we have a new variety as to whether or not consumers like it. It might be interesting, but whether or not someone will actually buy it and purchase the plant.
Are you rating them like a beauty pageant, or are you simply selling the stock?
Well, we sell the plants, and I sort of rate them in two levels. One of them is, can the grower produce it? It can be a really pretty plant, but if the grower can't produce it, it won't work in the marketplace. And then I rate them on whether or not the consumers like them. It could be a variety that's very easy for the growers to produce, but if no one's going to buy it, then it's a waste of time for the commercial folks.
Well, what don't they like? What color is the least likely that they
Well, it's interesting. Historically, red poinsettias are sort of the base, traditional type colors. And then we have had whites and pinks to also. And the general public really likes the red poinsettias much more, and they tend not to like the white and pink traditional poinsettias. The colors are not bright pink, and they're not a real bright white. They're not nearly as bright as some of the spring crops, for example, the spring species.
Where do the proceeds go to from the plant sale?
The students that grow the crop and sell them, they use it to they give some money back to the university to support some of the teaching program. They use it to fund grants for students that do research projects and travel to professional events, travel to visit commercial operations, botanical gardens in the U.S. and internationally.
Wow, that's exciting. Well, tell me a little bit about some of these varieties and why were they selected for them?
As I mentioned, this is the really traditional poinsettia. It's a nice, large red plant. The plant breeders have selected it for large bracts, so this is much larger bract, which is the flowering structure on a poinsettia, the color. This is much larger than a native plant. A native plant would be long and narrow, would not have near this much color on the top of the plant. Really, the native poinsettias are very weedy, so this is highly selected.
What's it called?
The poinsettia?
The variety.
Oh, this variety is called Neva.
Okay.
And so that's one of the new red varieties that is performing very well for us. So this is a traditional red. Around the world, about 80% of all the poinsettias that are sold are red.
Oh.
And in general, the poinsettias initially were imported in the U.S. and then spread to Europe, and now is pretty much spread around the world. Asian countries, Australia, South America, and it's an influence pretty much from the U.S. influence. And so the red is the dominant thing.
Okay, who's buying the white and the pink and the other alternative colors? What country? Or is it mostly us?
There's a little bit of the traditional whites and pinks, and right here in front we have a traditional pink variety that is really, it's sold a little bit everywhere, but the numbers are not real big.
Why not?
Again, it's not quite as bright pink as a lot of the traditional spring flowering crops might be. And one of the places that we're going with poinsettias is toward brighter colors. And this is, while this red plant is the traditional one, we're looking at some of the other things. Let me show you this plant over here. This is a poinsettia. This is actually a hybrid between two species, poinsettia and another euphorbia species, that's a weed with a white flower.
Okay.
And the traditional poinsettias, we have difficulty getting clear white and real clear pinks. But with this hybrid that's difficult to produce, we're getting much brighter pink colors, and we're finding this variety, the name of this variety is Love You Pink.
Okay.
And it has been in the market about 2 years now. It is being what we're finding is that consumers like this. Even if someone is a traditionalist,
yes.
And that's one of the things about consumers, they're highly varied. But what I describe as a traditional consumer of poinsettias that like the red color, we find that they will buy a group of red plants, but then at our poinsettia show and sell, they will often buy some pinks just because they're so bright.
But so often I've heard of people see these new varieties and we can't get our hands on them. How soon can we get them to market? And where would somebody buy something like this? I haven't seen this at the big box stores. How would I get my hands on them and the viewers get their hands on these?
The newer and the more novel the variety is, the more difficult it is to find until it gets a little bit more established in the marketplace. This is so non-traditional, we don't think of pink as being useful in Christmas decorations very much. However, I was at a meeting today of gardening group, and this woman was talking about, and she showed me pictures of her tree with pink decorations on it, and it worked for her. She had a whole group of pink poinsettias. So since they're sort of non-traditional, it takes a little longer for them to get into the market. So the consumer would have to do a little shopping and probably look a little bit more at independent garden centers who would specialize in something that's a little bit more unique. And
is
more
that online stores?
Sometimes online, but I would generally suggest checking with local independent garden centers.
Okay. Yeah. Now, you have this pink, but the one in front of me is more of a pastel pink.
Yes,
equally
as
stunning. Tell me, what was it selected for, and is this a direction we are going, or is it still...
That is a direction that we're going. Actually, this plant is a more pastel pink, and so in this hybrid that the breeder started working with, we're getting this bright pink. This particular plant is sort of interesting. This is not a named plant.
Why not?
Because this white over here on the far end of the table
is
a hybrid that has a bright white color to it, a clear white. That is the variety that's being introduced, and this is the first year that consumers might find it at a garden center. The name of that is Poinsettia Max White. And the reason this is interesting is because last year at our poinsettia show, that was one of the fastest selling varieties that we had. And so growers are selling them, they're growing them and putting them into retail. So that's Poinsettia Max White. This light pink one is a natural mutation that occurs from that white one.
Wow. So was it a sport, or did they cross pollinate?
No, it's natural. So where we grow 100 of the Max White, about 5 or 6 of those plants would be this pastel pink.
Is it true to type? Each year will it come that color, or could it get darker, or could it revert back?
We're learning that. That's part of what we need to do. So one of the things that I'm looking forward to at this year's Poinsettia Show and Sell is to see whether consumers like this pastel pink or not. If this is really something that consumers like, then we can go back to the breeder and talk to them about that, let them know that there is a market for this, and then they can propagate it and build up the numbers so that it can be a commercial variety. So this year, you cannot find this at retail. The only place you can see it would be in a research greenhouse.
Okay, is it gender specific? Like, do females like the pink and the males like the red, or is it any gender, or you can't classify it?
Well, in general, a lot of males don't care for pinks very much. And that's one of the things that's interesting about the bright pink. Even the non-pink guys react to this because it is so bright and novel. Personally, I tend not to like pink and flowers, but this is interesting to me. Now, this pastel pink, I personally don't care for very much. I like the bright white one out of this group. This one, sort of professionally, this one is interesting to me because it might be an important new variety. It might be would be interesting to me because consumers would like it. And then I can generate the information for the growers on how to produce it.
I see. We have a caller. Anita is on the phone. Hi, Anita. Welcome to the program. What's your question for Dr. Barrett?
Hi, Karen. I would like to know when the poinsettia sale is, and is it open to the public?
Sure. When is the sale?
Yes, the poinsettia sale is... It is a Thursday and Friday, and the Thursday is always 2 weeks after Thanksgiving. You can find information about it online if you do a search for GatorPoinsettias.com or University of Florida Poinsettias.
And it's in the campus?
Yes, it's on the UF campus, and it is open to the public. Like, we have over 1,500 people visit every year.
We've got a call from Cody from New Smyrna Beach. Hi, Cody. Welcome to the program. What's your question?
How's it going? I was wondering how much the poinsettias usually run in price.
Poinsettias, the price on poinsettias at retail really varies quite a bit from the retail and the size of the plant and that kind of thing. For this, these plants are in a fairly traditional pot that's 6.5 inches in diameter. And plants of this, for this, at this size, at retail will sell anywhere from probably $4 to probably $12, or depending on the retail store and what they're doing and how large the plant is.
Right. Yeah. Now, you also have some variegated ones. Tell me a little bit about them, and how did you come about the variegation, the sparkle effect?
Well, the this particular plant, and yes, the variegation where you have the different colors in the bracts, that's a variegated pattern. This container, I brought this on purpose because this is an example of what consumers could do themselves. The variegated plant and then a pure white plant, this is actually four different plants in one container.
This is beautiful. What's it called?
This one is called Red Glitter. That's the name of that one. The white one is called Primero White. And Primero is a variety that's used in Italy more than we use it in the U.S. But consumers can do this mixed container type look by going to a garden center. It's a little bit difficult this year, but going to the garden center in the first half of November to the first couple of weeks of November and buying small plants in a small container and then taking and buying the mix, whatever the colors that they want, and planting them in a container together. And so it can be very creative. It's something that children could have fun doing. And you can create different looks that you will not get necessarily in a single plant.
Okay. There's, now, you have another one over there.
Yes, so there's another example over here. And I'll just reach and grab that. And this is an example of a pink and white that's mixed together, and it's up to the individual preferences. You can do red and white, pink and white, or I see people that will mix red, pink, and white together.
Oh, wow.
That's not something, I mean, I've told traditionally you don't mix pink and red, but, you know. The pink one is called Polly's Pink, and the white is called Enduring White.
Okay. But it's clearly a different white than the pure white
Yes, you can see this, like most traditional poinsettias, the white is a little greener, a little yellowish cast. And that's one of the reasons I think by themselves the whites don't sell necessarily that well.
I see.
Yeah.
Now, you have another variegated one over there. Tell me a little bit about that one. It's still different than this one, but it has a just a gorgeous pattern.
I believe this is the one you were talking about.
Tell me a little bit. That's totally different than this one. Tell me how that was developed.
This is a very new variety. We grew it for the, and showed it to the public the first time last year.
What did they think of it?
They liked it a lot. This style plant, this particular plant is called Jingle Bell Rock. And this style of variegation in poinsettias, the biggest selling, which consumers tend to like this, we know that. The biggest selling variety is called Red Glitter that's in this group. Actually, this is Red Glitter right here. This is Red Glitter, and this is a Jingle Bell Rock. And you can see the difference in the two. Last year, the public at our poinsettia show and sale, they bought Jingle Bell Rock before they started buying Red Glitter. Distinctly different from in the past. And so our commercial growers, we communicated to them the importance of this, potential importance of this variety, and our commercial growers are producing it this year. And so this is available at retail for the first time this year.
Wow, it's a stunning color.
Yeah. And it's One of the things that happens in poinsettia is we see the demand for it and clearly in this case. And so the variety actually went to market a little bit too fast, because now this year, for at least the eastern half of the U.S. and particularly in the southeast, our temperatures have been much higher this year, which has been discussed in social media and the news, right, and things. And we can see that effect on poinsettias.
They don't like it.
The poinsettias don't like, they're native to the mountain areas, as you were indicating, of Mexico, Guatemala. They're not native to the coastal areas. They're not native to the real high temperature areas. And so some varieties are sensitive and they flower later at high temperatures. And so we're finding in Florida, for example, this variety this year, as opposed to last year, is flowering too late.
Okay.
And one that's under sort of natural Florida conditions is probably 2 weeks behind this particular plant. So this plant is working better in cooler climates than it is in our warmer climates. So as a physiologist who is trying to communicate to growers on how to do this plant, we have to do more research to figure out how to grow this plant under Florida conditions.
All right, speaking of growing them, if you wanted to take a poinsettia and plant it in your landscape in the state of Florida, how long would this plant stay red? Or how do you maintain it? Or
well,
do you just poinsettias
naturally are perennials. Now, they are sensitive to freezing. And so in cool climates where it's going to freeze, you really can't use them as perennials. In warmer climates, which would apply to the southern part of the U.S., Texas, and parts of California, Florida, the plant can be a perennial. However, the plant that you use in your home under the real low light conditions, the carbohydrate reserves, the energy in the plant is all used up when it's in that low light. And by the time you take the plant outside in the spring and plant it, it's very weak. And so usually in that situation, the pathogens knock the plant out. So probably 80% of the plants that are handled like that die. What I recommend if someone is in a warm climate and they want to use a plant like this as a landscape plant is to buy the plant and take it home and keep it in a high light area. So in a porch or a patio or at least by a window. And even in cool climates, the best way to keep a poinsettia in your home is the higher light level, the better. Poinsettias are not indoor foliage plants. They need light. And so even in a cool climate, if you take a plant, it looks good, you take it home, and after 2 or 3 weeks, the carbohydrate reserves are starting to run out, starting to stress a little bit. And so if you place it in the middle of your home where it's darker, the plant will go downhill faster. Leaves will start dropping, the bracts will start getting diseased and start falling off. So the higher light, so even in a cool climate, next close to a window, something like that. And like a lot of plants, you want to keep them away from air conditioning vents or heating vents because that dries the plant out a little bit faster.
Right. Yeah. Now, you determine trends. What do you foresee the future? What are the younger generation buying compared to the older generation? And what do you, if you had a crystal ball, what direction would you see poinsettias going, color-wise?
Sort of two ways. I think the traditional is going to continue being the traditional. And so the base of red being most important, yeah, I think it's going to continue. However, it's real clear that for bringing more consumers into the market, the novel things is what's working. And I think we will continue seeing that. I think the using hybrids to create different looks and different forms is where we're going. I have another plant over here. I'll pull it over. This is also a very new variety. This is not on the market yet. This is an experimental variety with white through the middle and pink around the outside of the bracts. A different look. There's not another poinsettia. It's the first time really we've had something like this. There's a variety we call Ice Punch that's real popular with consumers. And this is a mutation from Ice Punch.
Okay.
It has a similar pattern, but the pink and the white are different. And so we'll be showing this to consumers this year to see what their response is, to see whether or not we go back to the plant breeder and to the wholesale growers to see whether or not it's worth making a variety like this. But it's looking for those novel things.
And I see you have some with the bracts that are curled up like a little rose shape.
Yes.
The one next to you, that one's also very interesting.
Yeah, and this...
Is that popular with consumers?
Well, this is interesting. This is called Winter Rose. Winter Rose Dark Red is the name of the variety. And it's because the bracts are curled into what looks like, if you use your imagination, a rosebud.
Yes, it does.
And it's a very, it's still red, and so it fits into the holiday color schemes, but it looks very different from the traditional poinsettia. Now, the winter rose types have been around in the market for about 15 years. And it was one of the things that made a real breakthrough early, when the commercial breeders and growers saw that something other than the traditional red could be important, because this variety was in the background, but the commercial folks tended to think that it looked so non-standard that there wasn't going to be a demand for it. It wasn't until we started showing it to consumers that the commercial people saw that there was real value in this variety. So this was the first novelty variety about 15 years ago that started a trend toward things that weren't just a standard red look. And then that's led to, we have another variety, it's called Carousel, and there the bracts are in a swirl.
Wow.
And it looked, you know, if you think of a carousel as swirling,
yeah,
that's what it is. And so bringing these novel things in, this was a trendsetter from that standpoint. So this is still an important variety. It's not as novel in the market as it once was, but you can still find it. And we find that there are many consumers know the variety, and they like this winter rose type.
Wow. Well, that's all the time that we have, and I hope we've helped answer some of your questions. And I'd like to thank my guest, Dr. James Barrett, and thank all of you for joining in the program with your questions on poinsettia. Keep your emails coming at wdsc@daytonastate.edu or friend us on Facebook. Join me again next week on Gardeners Hotline.